Enormous bloated warriors festering with pustules and plague, putrid blightkings are the favoured mortal servants of Nurgle. Now in this video we're going to show how to paint one of these models, and we're going to paint them following the contrast method and up to battle ready. Now the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model, and as you can see here I've gone with grey sear, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be using in this video. Now the first contrast paint we're going to use is plague bearer flesh, which we're going to be applying to the skin. So I'm just going to give that pot a quick shake, pop it open. And then what I'm going to do is we're using a medium layer brush for this. And like I said, we're just doing it on the skin. So what I'm going to do is load my brush up a little bit, apply a little bit to the palette. This is mainly so I don't overload the brush too much and get a nice point to it as well. And all we then do is then just start applying that to the skin. If you do make any mistakes in other areas, just tidy back up with grey sear. There we are with the skin now done. We're going to move on to applying some more contrast paints. We're going to start with the armour, and for this we'll be using Creed Camo. Then we're going to move on to paint any metal details using Basilicane Grey. For the dark leather we're going to be using Wildwood, and for the warm leather and also any brass details we're going to be using Gore Grunter Fur. So first of all, let's apply that Creed Camo. So I'm just going to get a little bit onto my palette again. Again, just so I don't overload my brush too much and get a nice point to it. And then we'll start applying to the armour details. So you've got his helmet to do, you've got his shoulder pauldron, and then his greaves and boots to do as well. With the armour now done, we're going to move on to using Basilicane and Grey, and we're going to be doing this on the metal areas. With the metal areas now done, we're going to move on to using Wildwood, and this is for the dark leather areas as well as the wood areas. With the Wildwood now applied and dry, we're going to move on to using Gore Grunter Fur. We're going to apply this to any light leather straps as well as the bells. With the Gore Grunter Fur now done, we're going to move on to applying the last few contrasts. We're going to start by using Iodine Yellow for any boils and pustules. We'll then move on to Skeleton Horde for any bone details. And finally, for the tentacles and exposed flesh, we'll be using Gulliman Flesh. So first of all, let's start with that Iodine Yellow. Now, before you start applying this to the actual pustule areas, it's worth just rebase coating those pustules with grey sear. Once you've done that, you're ready to start splodging this on. So I'm just going to start doing a couple of little dollops around here, like so. There we are with the pustules done. We're now going to move on to applying Skeleton Horde to any bone details. On this model, it's just going to be the horn. With the horn now done, we're going to move on to painting the tentacles, and for this we'll be using Gulliman Flesh. Now when doing the tentacle itself, it's worth just rebase coating over grey sear, just so it's nice and crisp and bright. But for all the other torn flesh areas, like around his belly, it's actually quite nice if you leave that with plague bearer flesh, because it'll give it more of a rotten look. There we are, with all the contrast paints now applied and dry, we're ready to add some texture to the base. Now for this we'll be using Valhalla Blizzard, so I'm just going to grab my texture tool. I'm going to start with the large side first. I'm just going to scoop some out onto that large side, and we're ready to start dolloping that actually onto the base. Now before you start actually applying this on, it's worth just tidying back up with that base with like grey sear, just in case you've got any paint splotched on it. Once this is all applied on, you want to leave it for about an hour to dry, and then paint the edge of the base in a colour that matches your board and your army. For this one, we're going to be using Steel Legion Drab. There we are, with the texture now dry and the rim of the base now painted, our Putrid Blightking is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when painting Putrid Blightkings with contrast paints, it's better to start with the skin first and add other colours after, like the armour and leather, like we did in this video. And also when using contrast paints, try not to overload your brush, as it can quickly run out of control. If this does happen, just use your brush to soak up any of that excess, and remember you can always reapply grey sear after, then reapply those contrast paints when that's dry. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video, hope you enjoy painting your own battle ready Putrid Blightkings, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.